All right, guys, welcome back here to KL Golf and Country Club here in Bukit Kiara. Now, remember, guys, we are going on to hole number 13. Let's get right to it here. I have a little bit of a different setup just so you guys can see maybe the holes just a little better action-wise. That way you guys can always remember who's playing where. And then I did just change up the putts. I know you guys can't see that clutch putting or the normal putts, but I'll read it off to you when you guys get it, need to. I had contention golfers, same place, over to the right. And then, of course, the dice tray is a little bit higher up. But either way, guys, let's get right to it. And I thank you very much, guys, for all your appreciation. Of course, school is getting underway and spring break has just ended, to give a little time stamp on when this was. And well, that's what my work is used for, right? Hospitality. So, all right, we'll see what we can do here on hole number 13, as we're going to see Sam Snead and Gene Littler go up to hole number 13, which is that semi-daunting, challenging hole. It is the Capital City Gauntlet, concludes with a tough uphill hole that demands accuracy and length. Now, remember, the last three holes have been absolute thrillers and very difficult, averaging over par for each one of them. This one's probably going to be no exception here. So Gene Littler here on a semi-daunting. Roll the dice here. That's out of view there. I'll pull up forward there. So a four. There we go. So a four is what we got. And a four on a semi-daunting, that's going to be a par. So he pars it out there. That is his... And that's just keeps parring it out here, guys. I think he's parred every hole in the back nine, so that's great for him. All right, so our next guy's gonna be Sam Snead. Now, Sam Snead definitely wants to make a move here. It is the 13th hole, only so many holes left. So with that, he's gonna roll ourselves here a four, so that's gonna be a four. So let's see, that means the hole controls, and a 66, which is not bad for this hole here, guys. That means it's gonna be a golf cam course. All right, so golf cam course is what we're looking at here. And the golf cam course says for a one green, it says here, cordial hole or laser golfer. Is he a laser golfer? Let's check it out. He is not, unfortunately. All right, so with that said here, nice save from rough to outer part of green, clutch putt for par. You guys can see the bottom part of the clutch area there. Barely, probably, right? But a 1-3 is where he's going to be. He's a semi-rust, though, so that means he's going to have a 1-2 to make this clutch putt for par. And he rolls a 3, guys. That's not good for him. So he's going to miss that, and that's going to be a bogey attempt here. It's going to be easy, though, so it's not going to be terrible. Unfortunately, though, he's going to get a red chip, which pretty much means he's going to be probably taken out of the area contention here if one of these leaders birdies. So he makes that bogey putt, and that'll be a bogey 5. Oh boy. Okay, well, that's another hole that's over par here on the Capital City Triangle, or Capital City Gauntlet, as they say. All right, so let's go back to hole number 12, and that'll start off with Vijay Singh and Ted Kroll, who's out of contention, but Vijay is not. So Vijay here. All right, hole number 12. It's that semi-daunting, semi-challenging par 4, 479 yards. Play it straight forward, rolls a 1. Course controls on this. This is a very difficult hole, trifecta. Each one of these holes, unless you roll a 6, that's it. The hole controls. There's nothing else to it. So with that being said here, guys, a 1 means the hole controls, and that's going to be a 34. So a 34 here on this one says it'll be also a golf cam course. So these two guys have actually had a pretty good go at it here. A 1 green means cordial hole or laser golfer. Is he a laser golfer? He is. You look at that right there on his irons. He's a laser golfer. So with that being said here, it's going to be an accurate shot, clutch putt for birdie. Now, he's a semi-rust as well, so he has the opportunity to make this birdie opportunity if a 1-2, or he can roll the desire die to get rid of the clutch completely, or the rust, and I will do so with Vijay. Let's roll the dice here for him. So it says no, and if he had gotten the rust taken off, he would have made that 3, so unfortunately for him, he will miss this putt here, guys, and get himself a red chip for that clutch putt. But he will have an easy putt for par. So let's see how that one plays. 33, that's an easy putt for par. All right, there you go. So a 4 par 4, he stays on that one. All right, Let's go over to his playing companion, Ted Kroll, who is out of contention. But this semi-daunting hole here will demand him to roll one die, and he rolls a six. That's going to be an easy bogey for him, unfortunately. And that is unfortunate as he's out of contention. He just keeps burying himself further out of contention. All right, so with that said here, let's take a look here. We have ourselves now Dal Finsterwald and Tommy Aaron. Tommy Aaron, Dal Finsterwald. Dal Finsterwald is right here. Okay. All right, so let's roll here. They're on hole number 11, start of the Capital City Gauntlet, which is difficult. The first of three consecutive holes that are very difficult. He rolls a five. That's course controlling. Lots of course control. 36, which will be a first shot into the sand. All right, so first shot into the sand is an easy one to find. It's right here on the first one, and a two green on a par three, as it would seem here. Is he a sandy golfer? He is not a sandy golfer, so sand flies, ball rolls onto green, moderate putt for par. So he's got a moderate putt, which is a 1-5. Remember, you guys can't see that card here, unfortunately, but a 1-5, and he rolls a four, so there you go. So a 1-4 right there for us. He makes himself a nice, easy par there to start off the gauntlet for him. We're going to go over to the one of the leaders here, though, Tommy Aaron, who has a chance to push out Sam Snead and gain sole possession of the lead here. All right, let's see what he's going to do here as he rolls the dice. He rolls a 5, which means course controls, and that's going to be a 16 on that one. And you guys are wondering how it is. It's a black and low to high, so black and gray die together. So that's a 16, 1-6. And a 1-6 is going to be golf cam course, so he has a pretty easy break here, but on a par 3, this could be something messy here for him. All right, so why am I looking at the actual golf course? There we go. Let's look here. Golf cam. There we go. And on a par 3, 6 says, is it a daunting hole or a hacker golfer? Semi-daunting hole. Decider Dice says not to that here, guys, which means that we're going to actually see him be able to have a normal or easy. With that, guys, the Decider Dice says it's not a daunting hole because that's a semi, and the Decider Dice says no to that there, guys, which means for this one, it says, otherwise, solid tee shot leaves excellent opportunity, clutch putt for birdie. Well, he's got a neutral spot here, so let's see how he does. It's going to be a 1-3 here, clutch putt for birdie. And he rolls a 5. So there it is, guys. This gauntlet continues here, folks. He gets himself an easy putt for par here to clean up the area, and he does make that par. So there you go, guys. That's going to be the first group here. At least the leader is not making any moves there. So we'll see what happens here on hole number 10 here for our next golfers, Fred Couples and Raymond Floyd. All right, so with that, that's going to bring us to hole number 10, which will be right here, that semi-cordial par 5, 559 yards. Now, this one will actually be for Fred Couples and let's see here, Raymond Floyd, who is also one of our co-leaders. So let's check that out here, guys, as we get over there. So it's going to be Fred Couples here. And that'll lead us here to our first one. Now, it's good to remember, guys, Fred Couples is only 3 shots back, and he has basically all of the back 9 to go here. So this is a great opportunity for us to watch somebody who could really make a move here, and I hope he does. All right, so let's see here. So we have a 1 here on this par 5. That's going to be an easy opportunity for him to take control. That's a 1-3-3 there. So a 1-3-3 on the books here on a par 5 for Fred Couples. Could be a big one here. He is a bomber and a legend golfer. Okay, so 1-3-3 says here, is he a yeoman or puny? He is neither of those. Is he a hero iron player? He is a hero iron player. So launched high and long. Go to the gallery chart. All right, so look at that gallery. Cheers. So he's going to get himself a blue chip. That's going to help him along the way of this back 9 for sure. And then also on top of that, for the gallery cheers, the 1 green, that says he's a champion iron player, and he is. So a great champion iron player, precise swing, sends ball rolling toward pin, gimme putt for birdie. All right, so gimme putt for birdie for Fred Couples. There you go. Nothing gets easier than that, pretty much. 2 dice here for birdie. That's a 26. That gets him a birdie there. So, guys, at this point, we're actually seeing here that currently that hole is playing well under a par five. It's playing at 486. So everyone's pretty much birdieing that hole, it looks like, besides, I suppose, Vijay Singh. So Raymond Floyd is next there, playing a partner here. Now, he does have a blue chip, so I'm going to actually use that, spend it right now here. You know what? Actually, no, I'm not going to, because everyone's really been playing that hole really well. I'm going to keep it for him, knowing that it's not a hard hole as it is, and I'm going to actually make it so that he's going to play it, just because of the fact that if it's so easy, he's probably going to end up doing super well on it. All right, so he gains control, because he has to have a 5 to not gain control. 225 on a par 5. So let's see here, 225. Says 225. Is he a legend driver? So on his woods, he is. So TV-worthy drive, fortuitous roll. There you go. That's why you don't play that chip, that blue one here. That is definitely something big here. So gallery cheers, tee shot, par 5. All right, so 5 green. Says here, is he a hacker? He is not a hacker. So strong second shot dampened by not so great bounce and roll. Strong applause. Okay, so strong applause is what we're going to look at now here. And it says a white 1. Okay, so let's roll that to 4. So 4 says, drifting iron, almost misses green. Difficult putt for birdie. Well, good thing he's got two chips here. He can make that difficult, a moderate, and then easy. And I think he's going to right now, actually. He's going to turn that really rough shot there that almost missed the green there into a really fortuitous roll, just like it says. So it's a 1-4 chance here for Raymond Floyd to take sole advantage of this lead. And he rolls a 2 there, guys, and he rolls himself right into the lead. And my friends, that's going to say goodbye to Sam Snead there. He doesn't even need that red chip anymore. He's going to be out of contention. That's going to bring all these guys all the way down here. And that's going to be very, very special for our now leader by himself. So let's see if he can take advantage of this great opportunity here, guys, as he, of course, stands alone at the top of the leaderboard with Tommy Aaron now falling behind, not because of anything he's done, but by the fact that Raymond Floyd now currently is 16 under par, as far as I can tell here, guys. All right, so with that being said, let's check out Gene Saracen, Tom Kite. Tom Kite was definitely with Gene Saracen, really getting close to the leader here. But looks like as he's playing, he's getting him further and further back. So hole number 9 here is going to be what we're looking at. And hole number 9, hole number 9 is a par 4, 404 yards here. Tom Kite, I believe. No, Gene Saracen is first. There we go. I was going to roll for either of them, so it doesn't much matter. 4 here means the course controls. That's going to be a 1-5. 1-5 says it's going to be a first shot into the trees. Okay, so first shot into the trees is what we're looking for here. All right, so first shot into the trees says on a par 4. All right, so par 4, first shot into the trees. A 6 green says, is he a master recovery? He is not. So with that being said, it says here, troublesome lie produces uncomfortable shot. Follow-up iron to fringe of green. Double difficult putt for par. Yikes, so Gene does not do very well here, guys. And that's going to leave a double difficult putt for par, which is a 1, essentially. Now, he can take a lag putt, which I think he's going to make sure he doesn't miss that difficult putt for bogey. And that could be really offsetting for him if he misses that. So he's going to miss this. He's going to lag the putt up for par to make it so it's a moderate putt for bogey. And he rolls a 1, so that's going to get him a bogey there, guys, as he does lag it up there. But that does secure him with an easy bogey, which is not a bad idea. Just think about it, guys, because he has a 1-3 chance of making it with that difficult shot there for a bogey. And if he missed that one, right, he wouldn't have if he rolled the 1. But playing it smart like a golfer would, you would not want to miss that opportunity for sure, if the match is on the line for it. So with that being said, let's look over at Tom Kite is what we're looking at next. All right, so Tom Kite on the same hole here. All right, so it says here we got ourselves a 1, so that's going to be him controlling the hole, and it's going to be a 225. So a 225 on a par 4. So a 225 on a par 4 is what we're looking at now. All right. 225 says here. All right. Is he a legend iron player? Is he a legend wood? He is. So that says finds the sweet spot gallery cheers chart. That is what we're looking for. So gallery cheers, we're going to give him a blue chip here. There you go. And then on top of that here, we're going to see a 5 green, which means, I apologize, if he's is he a hacker? He is not. So nice shot. It hits green regulation. Moderate putt for birdie. All right, it's a moderate putt for birdie, which means it's going to be a 1-2-2. So 1-2 here for birdie. He can use a blue chip to make that an easy one, and I think he's going to make that an easier putt, make it a little bit more focused, you know, a little more readable. 1-4 opportunity. He misses it, guys. That's a 5. So he's going to have himself an easy putt for par. And he makes a 16, so that's not too bad. That's going to be a par for him. And that will level off Tom Kite there, a par 4. I apologize, a 4 there. So there you go. And so just to kind of wrap it up here for you guys, so you guys know, Tom Kite shot a 3-under for the back or the front 9. And then Gene Saracen shot 1-under. So definitely a tale of two golfers there, as well, it looks like to me at this point. Tom Kite is really trying to work himself through here, getting 2 strokes above his playing partner. But let's go back to our day's early leaders, Payne Stewart and Gary Player. Payne Stewart is our first one here, and then Gary Player. They're on hole number 8. They're the last ones here to be on the front 9, I apologize, guys. All right, so we have ourselves here at 5. That's going to be a course controls, 34. It's going to be a golf cam course. All right, so he rolls a 5 on a par 3. It says here, 5, is it a cordial hole? It is not. So it's not a daunting hole. Makes this one and moves on. So an easy 2-putt for par. All right, let's see if he overthinks this one here. This is an opportunity for an overthinking Payne Stewart. He rolls a 36, so it just lips right in there, guys, and gets himself a par. And let's move over to Gary Player, his playing companion, who has a blue chip. He could utilize this one here. I don't think he's going to. I think he's going to keep that for an opportunity for putting. All right, so he gains control of the hole there, which is great. So it's going to be a 1-2-4. So a 1-2-4 is what we're looking at here for a par 3. So Gary Player is going to try to see if he can show off his prowess on this par 3. 1-2-4 says, is it a firm green? It is not a firm green on this par 3 here, which means it's going to go to the golf cam course. Or golf cam green, I apologize. Golf cam green with a 2 green. Says, is it a friendly green? It is a friendly green. So shaky shot held by green. Clutch putt for birdie. All right, so clutch putt for birdie. That, I think, he's going to utilize. Man, this is a question that really could pull the heartstrings here, guys. I'm wondering, does Gary Player want to take the opportunity to spend that blue chip and make himself a gold clutch putter, right? Because that's an opportunity for sure. But if he spends it, he doesn't get a blue chip back. So he's basically spending it to get himself that birdie. But if he doesn't use that blue chip, think about this, the strategy wise, if he doesn't use that blue chip and he does make it, because it's a 1-3 opportunity, so 50-50 chance, he will get another blue chip. So he'll have 2 blue chips going into the back 9, and that, speaking of which, would be for, you know, help him out through that gauntlet holes up here on the top. So I think, all right, so let's think here. We're going to use the decider die. We're going to use yes and no. So yes, use the blue chip. No, don't use the blue chip. Okay, here we go. And it says no. So decider die says no to us. So there you go. That's easy enough for us. We're not going to use the blue chip. So we're going to use a 1-3 neutral putter for birdie here. It's a clutch putt here, guys. And he should have. Look at that. So he's going to miss that putt, and he's going to gain himself a red chip, which means he's going to lose the blue chip. So Gary Player, you know, is talking to his caddy. He's thinking to himself, man, I should have done that, right? So now he loses that blue chip. He makes a nice par putt there, but definitely a shaky hole for him. All right, let's look at our last hole here before we cut off for the emerging golfers opportunity here at the KL Golf and Country Club in Bukit Kiara. Now that we have a couple golfers who are out of contention right here, that does make this gameplay speed up just a little bit, which is nicer. It's kind of nice when you have that, especially if you have a full set of pairings, a full leaderboard. When you have games like this, where you have tons of golfers all set up and all playing in contention, it does tend to bog down the game a little bit if you have, you know, if you can't just play one, if you don't mind. If you have to play the game or a tournament in all in one day, that's going to make it more difficult for you for sure. All right, let's get right back to it here, guys. Hole number 14, it's a par 4. So let's scoot everybody down the line here as I mess up all the cards. All right, so we have ourselves 10, 11 here. So everyone now is going to be ending their par, the front 9, that number 9 hole here, as the last golfers are leading off there. And we're going to see hole number 14 here. Hole number 14 says it is a par 4, 358 yards. The fairway in green, wrap around the water hazard at 14. This is a hole that plays easier than it looks due to its manageable length. As you guys can see, there are the water shots here, which are very difficult, especially that second one. That's a really tough one, and the sand bunkers that kind of corral the hole here. So absolutely can see that this hole can be very difficult, but you may want to consider conceding the hole here to the hole. You know, don't use any blue dice here to get control of the hole, because of the fact that if you look at all these beautiful fairway shots here on the left, or the middle and the right side of the hole. All right, so enough of that here. Let's get right to the action. And our first golfers, it's going to be Sam Snead and Gene Lillar, who are both out of contention, so we won't even have to look at it. It's going to be cordial for both of them there, guys. So let's look at Gene Lillar first. And a six here for a cordial. It's going to be a decide or die first, because you have to say whether or not it's going to be a bogey or a par, and it's going to be a bogey. So unfortunately for him, he's going to bogey that hole there. And now we're going to move up to Sam Snead, who is also going to roll here. And that's a three, so that's going to be a par. There you go. So par for Sam Snead there. So that's a nice par four for him. And now we're going to move on to Vijay Singh and Ted Krull. So Vijay Singh here has got that red chip. Now, I'm not sure if he wants to. I think he's going to utilize it now. Let the hole control here. But it's just thinking here, guys. Look at this. He can get himself a black six, which would basically secure him a six on this chart here if he were to not miss it, right? So a six, 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 six. So I'm going to actually use this, not to concede the hole, concede a black six, because all the sixes besides one is a golf course controls. That can really help out, just to make sure you bank on the fact that you at least have something to help you out if the course somehow randomly controls. All right. Sorry guys for the cut here. I actually made a mistake. I was actually showing you guys the pole 14 as if it was where Vijay and Ted Krull were at. It is not. They're actually at hole number 13. So they did roll 226, right? With that being said, a 226 on this one here would actually mean it's going to be a 26, which is a golf cam course. So that instead of all of, I actually went through a whole different thing to get a possible thing for Vijay. It's actually a golf cam course. So I almost messed up here, guys, but just to show you, no matter how many tournaments you do, sometimes mess up anyways, but it's good to catch yourself if you can. So a two green on a par four says, is it a cordial hole? It is not. It is a cordial hole. It is not a daunting hole. It's a semi-daunting hole. The decider die says no to that. So it says solid play, easy two putt for par. So there you go. Easy two putt for par for Vijay Singh. And we have ourselves not a bogey. So there you go. So he pars that hole, and that is exactly how I actually had it there for him. So let's see if we can get that all set up here, guys, with the right quality and attribute that we can here for us. All right, now I use my computer here, so that's probably why you're wondering where I actually am looking off camera real quick here and typing in here. Is actually I use it for a leaderboard, just so that I have it all set up, just a nice little leaderboard for myself, not actually automating the system at all. But with that being said, let's look over at Ted Krull, who, if I can make sure I have that right, is going to be up for hole number 13 now, and he is semi-daunting. So it's a semi-daunting hole here for Ted Krull, who is out of contention if you look over here. All right, so there we go. So five on a semi-daunting, it's gonna be a par. So he gets a par there, and that will leave him with a par for himself. All right, so right now we're gonna go down to Dal Finsterwald and Tommy Aaron, one of our leader, or what used to be leader here, on hole number 12. Okay, so hole number 12, par 4, 479 yards. Hole controls, it's going to be a 24. 24 is going to be a golf cam green. There you go for Dal Finsterwald, who really is turning on the gun here, possibly. He's four shots off the lead now, and that could be a real big hindrance if he does not make a move here. So a six green says, is it a friendly green or a laser golfer? Well, he's not either of those. That's not a friendly green. On the green in two, but with distance pin. To pin, birdie putt misses, leaving clutch putt for par. Now he's a neutral putter, so he's just gonna have a 1-3 opportunity. And he rolls a one, so there you go, guys. That's one we're looking for. He's gonna get a par, and that's, of course, something to cheer about because he now has a blue chip. And now we're gonna look at Tommy Aaron. That blue chip is gonna be crucial as he finds himself with 6 holes left. That's plenty of time to make a move if he can. All right, so Tommy Aaron is up next here, guys. He's got a red chip here. I'm gonna let him keep that one just right now, and that is a good opportunity to do so. All right, so he is going to concede the control of the hole, of course, because rolls a 1 and that 1 right here for that number 12. And a 13. 13 is going to be a golf cam course, so both of these guys actually get pretty good drives off the tee here. And we're going to be looking at the 6 greens. It's a daunting hole. It's a semi-daunting hole, right? And a daunting hole says yes to that desire die. So, yes it is. Battles back from tough lie to make green in 2. Clutch putt. 2 putt for par. So he's a 1-5, a 1-3 because he of course is neutral. So this could be a big putt for him here, guys. A 1-3 opportunity for par. And he rolls a 2, guys. So there you go. He makes that one here for par, and he gains himself a blue chip, which of course means he negates that other red chip that he already has. Let's look at Fred Couples now. Fred Couples and his playing partner, Raymond Floyd, who of course finds himself in the lead again. This is fantastic. A golfer who is not a 1 in tournament play is leading again. He's making a name for himself in this tour for sure. With that being said, Fred Couples is on hole number 11, that par 3. It's a semi-daunting hole. Remember, this is the gauntlet right here, guys. The gauntlet that is really difficult here. All right, so does he want to get control of the hole here? I'm not sure if he wants to. I think he's just going to play it smart here and just kind of keep it for putting. It's a smart play. So 3 means it's going to be golf course controls, and 11 means it's going to be a first shot into the trees. Yikes, that's not good here. So first shot into the trees is what we're looking at on a par 3. And on a 3 green, it says here, is he a workman? He is not a workman for sure. He's not that. He is a semi-utility, but not a workman. Ball hit cleanly from beneath tree, rolls to within a foot of pin. Gimme putt for par. All right, so three dice here for par. And that's going to be easily made there, so that's a par. You have to roll 3 sixes, so that's much difficult. That's very difficult for him. So, all right, Raymond Floyd is up next, and that's going to be our golfer leader here on this par 3. So let's see if he's going to be able to handle this gauntlet pretty well. Course controls, 5-6. 5-6 is going to be a first shot into the water. Okay, so our leader might be changing here soon here on a par 3. First shot into the water. A 5 green says, is he a hero? He is a hero iron player, so he's probably going to get it right there. After drop, determined shot, finds heart of green, easy putt for bogey. All right, so there's an easy putt for bogey. Two dice here for him for a bogey, so that's going to move everybody up here. And guys, he rolls a 66. That means he misses the easy putt for bogey, and he's going to have If a putt is missed, the next putt is the next easiest level. So that'd be a gimme putt, right? So a gimme putt. Wow, guys, gimme putt for a double bogey. So he's going to 2 putt this one here, and that's a double bogey for Raymond Floyd. So 1 and then 2. This is insane. I haven't seen that. He really got worked over by that par 3. That is insane. So with that being said here, guys, we're going to see now Tommy Aaron's going to take sole possession because of a double bogey by Raymond Floyd. Yikes. I don't think I've seen a double bogey played so crucially since Jack Nicklaus did it, I think, in the previous tournament out in China. He double bogeyed himself out of the tournament, I think, actually. But with that being said, now, guys, this tournament is wide open. We're going to look at Gene Sarazen and Tom Kite, who are finding themselves a little bit more into the tournament now, just as we are looking at it here. Hole number 10 is where we're looking at now here, guys. We're going to see a semi-cordial hole here. All right, so he rolls a 4, so that's going to be him controlling, and it's going to be a 4-5-6 on a par 5. This could get ugly here, guys. A 4-5-6 may not be something good, but it could be something. You never know. 4-5-6. Ooh, that's a good one here, guys. So it says 4-5-6. Go to golf cam. All right, so there you go. Golf cam here on a par 5. This could be a big one here. Is it a 5 green? Is it a friendly green? It is not. Yikes. It's not a challenging green, so breezes to green, easy, 2 putt for par. Wow, he could have had an opportunity for birdie if he had made that, or friendly green. So 2 putt, clutch, did it say clutch? I don't think it said clutch. Let me check here real quick. It says for a 5, no, it says easy 2 putt, so that's going to be two dice here, guys. All right, so we have ourselves 16. Okay, so 16, he makes that one there, guys. That's going to be a par 5, 5 par there. So Tom Kite is next up on the tee. Let's see how he does here at this par 5. All right, so a 6, that's easy for us here, guys. Now, it is a semi-cordial, it's not a double cordial, so he's still just going to get a par. He's going to par, and he's going to take it easy here, guys, because he knows when Tommy Aaron has to face through all these holes, he could possibly make a mistake, and he wants to get himself in position to be able to utilize those blue chips. So he's going to get a 5 there, and then it's going to be our last group before we end this video, and we're going to see the emerging leaders in the next video here, guys. It's going to be Payne Stewart and Gary Player. So Payne Stewart is actually making a run here for us. See if he's going to be able to continue this hot streak here and close out this front 9 under par. So we'll see how far he can go. Let's see here. So it's a par 4, 404 yards here. He rolls a 4, so that's going to be course controlling. 35 says that's going to be a golf cam course. So golf cam course, again, for Payne Stewart. 5 green says, is it a daunting hole or scatter golfer? Neither of those are what's happening here. He's a shaper, not a scatter. Longer than usual tee shot and well-played iron. Nice opportunity. Clutch putt for birdie. So is Payne Stewart going to take an opportunity to go up to the lead here, guys? He's a neutral putter, 1-3 opportunity, and he rolls a 2. That's exactly what he wanted. So, guys, Payne Stewart now has co-leaderboard here with Tommy Aaron. This could be a phenomenal finish. Am I seeing, what was it, the U.S. Open here, guys? Phil Mickelson, Payne Stewart in the air here, folks. Is Payne Stewart going to relive that memory and miss that opportunity? I don't think so here, folks. Let's try and see how Payne Stewart does. But first and foremost, let's try to see if we can finish off this last pairing, which will be Gary Player here. Now, Gary Player does want to make a move here before he goes into that gauntlet, the Capital City Gauntlet. He rolls a 1, so he's going to control the hole. That's going to be a 3-5-6 on a golfer control for a par 4. So a 3-5-6 says here, is he a scatter or puny? He is neither of those, so that's always good to know, of course, right? Champion iron player. He is a champion iron player. He's not a semi, so he's a champion. Yard from pin, 3 feet if you guys don't know that. Easy putt for birdie. Okay, so the easy putt for birdie, that's going to be a 1-4. All right, so let's see if he's going to birdie this one. And he rolls a 5. That's terrible luck. So it's going to be a 2 putt for par, and he makes that par. So, folks, those guys end off here, guys, at a 33 for Payne Stewart. So that's 3 under par for the day. And then over to Gary Player for 1 under. So, guys, currently the lowest score as of right now through 9, the lowest registered score was a 31 by Tommy Aaron. Of course, he's leading the league, right, guys? He is 5 under through 9 holes. But of course, other golfers have already passed through 9 holes and gone to hole number 14 already. But that is great to see that. And of course, Ted Kroll played himself out of contention, shooting a 1 over, but nothing beats Gene Littler shooting a 4 over par for 9 holes. That's rough. That's high school. That's Bush League, right? We'll see you guys next time here. We'll see who is going to be emerging here in this great course as we're seeing here. The course is playing pretty easy, playing around, I would say around 1 or 2 under par for the day, I suppose you could say. It's playing around that area. A lot of golfers are playing that. The only reason why it's playing 1 or 2 under is because these guys are playing so poorly over here. We'll see you guys next time. Of course, this video might be coming up a little bit earlier than the next one, just because I have a couple of projects I'm working on, as you guys are probably already well aware of with my activity on the Delphi forums and elsewhere. So guys, give me time as I do it. It is pretty busy out at work and school, so we'll see how I can get these videos out. Try to do daily content as much as I can, but with that being said, I'll see you guys next time in the bleachers. So thanks for watching, guys.